Last time we have seen the video of degrees of comparison. There are three types of degrees of comparison: positive, comparative and superlative. In our last video we have seen where to use positive, where to use comparative and where to use superlative, as well as we have seen few rules how to make superlative and comparative degree. I hope the concept of degrees of comparison is clear to you now. The same topic is also explained in your course book. So everyone open course book Seite Nummer 18. We'll read the explanation and understand the topic or revise the topic in short. Vergleiche. The Schulgebäude is fast so hoch wie die Bank. Der Kirchturm ist höher als die Bank. Der Fernsehturm ist höher als der Kirchturm. Und viel höher als das Schulgebäude. In der Stadt ist der Fernsehturm am höchsten. You can see the picture. That there is a picture comparison. They have shown that whenever, for example, Schulgebäude and Bank, both are at the same level. So they are so hoch wie. Compositive is used. Then there is a comparison between Kirchturm and the Bank. So, whenever there is a comparison between two things, we always use comparative degree. And in the last tense, there is a comparison among four things. Whenever there is a comparison among more than two things, then we use the superlative form. So, whenever both are at the same level, we use positive. Whenever there is a comparison between two things, we use comparative degree. And whenever there is a comparison among more than two things, we use superlative degree. I hope this concept is clear to you. List the adjective, markiere the adjective. Das Leben in einem Dorf ist wirklich angenehmer, billiger, ruhiger. Angenehmer is more pleasant, cheaper and more peaceful. Da ist die Luft auch besser. Wir Kinder haben viel mehr Platz als früher. We have lots of more place as than earlier. Das gefällt mir am meisten. Ist das Leben in einer modernen Stadt nicht am teuersten? Isn't the life in the modern city most expensive? Meine Stadt ist fast so groß wie die smart city von Andreas. Fast so groß is as big as. So which are the adjectives we can see here? Angenehmer, billiger, ruhiger, besser, mehr, am meisten, oder teuersten. Gross. These are the adjectives we see here, and these adjectives are used in different degree forms. Now we have already seen how we make positive, comparative and superlative degree. So meine Beobachtung, my observation, here you have to match the pair. Ordner zu. So for positive degree we use so plus adjective plus wie. For comparative, we use adjective plus er plus als. And for superlative, we use am plus adjective plus estn. So this is used for, these are the rules how to make positive, comparative and superlative degree. And the same type example is also given. You can see the picture, compare the height and then you can understand the sentences better. Max is so gross wie Tobias. Lukas is etwas grosser als Max und Tobias. Fabian ist aber viel grosser als Max und Tobias. Er ist am größten. I hope the concept is clear to you. That whenever there is a comparison, means both are at the same level like Max and Tobias, we have used positive degree. Whenever there is a comparison between Max or Lukas or Tobias or Lukas, then we have used comparative. And whenever there is a comparison among four people, we have used superlative degree. So I hope how to make comparative, positive and superlative degree is clear to you now. Now on course book Seite Nummer 19, there is a small table of degrees of comparison. In our video, degrees of comparison video, we have already seen the different cases, different rules to make the degrees of comparison. So we will just try to fill up this table. Okay. So klein wie, kleiner als, am kleinsten. So So for positive, zovi is used. Er and als is used for comparative. Am plus sten to the adjective is used for superlative. So you write in your book, you complete this table. Shown, zo shown vi, shoner als, am shonsten. Okay. Then angenehmer, zo angenehm vi, angenehmer als, am angenehmsten. Only sten is added. Then laut, zo laut vi, lauter als, lauter. But while making the superlative, as it is ending with t, we will add estn, am lautesten. I hope you remember the rule. Then ruhig, zo ruhishvi, ruhiger als, am ruhigsten. Normal. Billig, zo billigvi, billiger als, am billigsten. Bequem, zo bequemvi, bequemer als, am bequesten. No change. Zo stressishvi, stressiger als, am stressigsten. Sten, no change. Schlimm, zo schlimm vi, schlimm is bad. Schlimmer als, am schlimmsten. Sten. Schmutzig, zo schmutzig vi, schmutziger als, am schmutzigsten. Zo groß vi, größer als, am größten. Please remember, this is as an exception. Though it is ending with st, we don't add estn, rather we add only tn. Please remember gross superlative form as an exception. Then here we are adding, these are the einsilbige, that's why umlaut is added. So lang vi, länger als umlaut, am längsten, stn. So alt vi, älter als with umlaut, am ältesten. It is ending with t, so estn is added. Kalt, kälter als, am kältesten. Okay, once again estn is added. Then kurz, kurz, so kurz vi, without umlaut, kürzer als with umlaut, am kürzesten, because it is ending with z, so estn. Then hoch, zo hoch vi, johar als, please remember the comparative form of hoch also as an exception. Johar als, h o umlaut h e r als, am jochsten. Okay, na, zo na vi, neher als, n a umlaut h e r. But remember the superlative form of na as an exception, that is am nexten. C is added extra. You can see here. In hok, comparative form is different. In na, superlative form is different. So this specific one, please keep in mind. Am nexten. Zo teuer vi, teurer als. Now here also understand that spelling. T-E-U-E-R is teuer spelling, but teurer is T-E-U-R-E-R. Am teuerst. Dunkel also, the same rule is applicable like teuer. In that video we have already seen. Zo dunkel vi, dunkler als, am dunkelsten. While making superlative form, it comes the normal spelling. D-U-N-K-E-L-S-T-E-N. Okay. Then gut, besser, am besten is absolutely different. Feel, mehr, am meisten. Gern, lieber, am liebsten. So please remember. Learn the table so that it becomes easier to solve the exercise based on degrees of comparison. I hope the table is clear to you. Now let's solve the exercises based on degrees of comparison. Arbeitsbuch. Now open the Arbeitsbuch. Seite Nummer 100. Aufgabe 26. Antworte mit Ja oder Nein. Zum Beispiel, findest du Deutsch einfacher als Englisch? Ja, ich finde Deutsch viel einfacher als Englisch. Nein, ich finde Deutsch nicht so einfach wie Englisch. There are two ways questions are given. Either you can answer the question with ja or nein. If you are answering with ja, use the comparative form. If you are answering with no, use the positive form. One example I will show you. Findest du Bergsteigen schwieriger als Schwimmen? Ja, ich finde Bergsteigen viel schwieriger als Schwimmen. Nein, ich finde Bergsteigen nicht so schwierig wie Schwimmen. So it is up to you. You can choose any answer. This exercise we can do orally also in our live class. So we will discuss the same answers of this exercise in our live class. Now let's go to next exercise. Aufgabe 27 on the same page, Arbeitsbuch Seite Nummer 100. Was ist richtig? Here they have given mixed one. Means in some example positive degree is there, in some comparative, in some superlative. You have to decide that for that example, for that sentence, which degree form is appropriate. Let's solve first few. A. Arya findet ihr Tablet viel praktischer oder am praktischsten als den Computer. Now here we are comparing between tablet and computer. Whenever there is a comparison between two things, it is always better to use comparative degree. So here the correct answer is viel praktischer als. Is it clear? One more hint to decide this: whenever als is written, it shows that it is comparative degree. Okay. Then B1, this tablet is natürlich teurer oder teuer als the smartphone. Once again, here comparison is between tablet and smartphone. So you will use comparative degree. So the answer will be teurer. Is this clear? Say. Sabine liest Blogs genauso viel mehr wie die Zeitungsartikel. So here Zobi is used. Whenever Zobi is used, it is always positive degree. So whenever it is positive degree, the adjective will remain as it is. So the answer will be viel. Okay. Accordingly, you need to decide. The positive degree, comparative degree, we will see one more example also. D1, Karin sieht mehr am meisten Serien in Netflix. Here we are telling whatever she is doing the most. She watches most series in the Netflix. So here naturally it will be superlative degree. So if the comparison is between two things, use comparative. If comparison is among more than two things, use superlative degree, and if Zobi is given, use positive degree. So you try to solve the exercise. The answers of the same we will discuss in our live class. Okay. Now let's go to next exercise. Aufgabe 28 on the same page. Wie ist das Leben in deinem Land? In this exercise, all sentences are given with als only. As the sentences are given with als, it shows that automatically all the answers will be in comparative. Okay. So let's solve first 2-3 sentences. A. Ist der Alltag in deiner Stadt blank oder blank als in Deutschland? Alltag is daily routine and adjectives are given leicht und hard. Leicht means easy and hard means difficult or hard one. So here the answer will be naturally, is the daily routine in your city easier or more hard than in Germany? So leicht comparative form is leichter. It is normal, leichter. Okay. So leichter oder härter. Now here, in case of hart also, it is einsilbiger. So here it will be with umlaut, härter. Okay, so leicht, there is no change, only er is added. But in case of hart, umlaut and er both will be added. So hart, härter als, am härtesten, because it is ending with t. To wherever you want, just note down the comparative superlative forms of difficult adjectives so that before exam you can revise it. Now, B1, is the student and sal, number of students in your university, niedrig means low or higher than at us? So Nidrish, once again comparative form, you can simply add er, Nidrigar, it will be correct. In case of Hoch, the comparative form is Johar, H-O-umlaut, H-E-R, Johar als by uns. Okay, so Nidrigar oder Johar als by uns. I hope these two are clear. Now on the next page, page number 101, the remaining sentences are there. The same way, everywhere als is written, so you have to just put the comparative form of the adjectives given. I will just tell you the meanings of the adjectives given in the bracket. Einfach is simple, compliziert is complicated, viel means a lot, wenig means less, breit is broad, eng means narrow, billig means cheap, and teuer means expensive. So you solve these exercises, we will discuss the answers of the same in our live class. And now we will do the next exercise. On the same page, Arbeitsbuch Seite Nummer 101, 29 and water. They have just given the question and you are supposed to write the answers of the given question. All questions are in superlative. So you have to just write the answer and you have to keep the sentence in superlative. For example, A, was strings do am liebsten? All questions are personal response question. It is asked about you. What do you drink the most? Ich trinke Limonade am liebsten. Oder you can tell, ich trinke Cola am liebsten. Wo lernst du am besten? Where do you learn the best? Ich lerne zu Hause am besten. Ich lerne in der Schule am besten. Wohin reist du am liebsten? Where do you like to travel the most favorite? Ich reise nach Deutschland am liebsten. I like to travel to Germany. So, the similar way you have to write the answers of the next question. Welches Fach findest du am schwersten? Which subject do you find the most difficult? Welches Land findest du am schönsten? Which country do you find the most beautiful? Welche Schauspieler sind in Indien am popularsten? Which actor are we actors? This is the plural one. Sind is used. Please keep this in mind. Which actors are the most popular in India? Where is in deiner family am größten? Who is the eldest one in your family? Who is the youngest one in your family, H1? Where is in, okay, here größten and eldesten is used differently. Größten is the height wise and eldesten is the age wise. So accordingly you need to write. Welcher Sport ist für dich am abenteuerlichsten? Abenteuerlichsten bedeutet most adventure. Which sport do you feel that is the most adventure sport for you? And here you need to write the answers. Write it in the book itself or we can simply discuss the answers orally in our live class. I hope the exercise 29 is clear to you. Now, Aufgabe 30, on the same page, Arbeitsbuch Seite Nummer 101. Here also, it is again about superlative degree. Arbeitsbuch Seite Nummer 101. 30, wie gut kennst du dein Land? How well do you know your country? Ask your partner. Good start means welche start findest du am besten. They have given the adjective, you have to form it in the superlative form. For example, A1 is sauber means clean. Welche start findest du am saubersten? B, viel Luftverschmutzung. Viel Luftverschmutzung means lots of air pollution. Welche start hat am meisten Luftverschmutzung? Which city has the most air pollution? Teuer is expensive. Welche Stadt findest du am teuersten? Billig is cheap. Schön is beautiful. Bequem is comfortable. Welche Stadt am meisten Verkehr? Which city has the most traffic? And sicher is safe. So you you have to make the questions in the superlative form. Similarly, you write the answers of the same. We will discuss the answers in our live class. I hope the exercises till now are clear to you. Thank you, students.